Hello everyone, and welcome to my new course module, Linux High Availability Clustering. My name is Shikhar Verma, and I'm the instructor of this complete course module. I'm having 13 years of IT industry experience, and also I got an opportunity to work for many MNCs and global projects. I'm also a professional IT trainer. My skills are Linux administration, automation with Ansible, Shell scripting, Perl, HP Unix. So on the basis of my technical skills and many years of expertise, I have designed this course module. And this course module is aimed at senior system administrator who are responsible for providing the fault tolerance through high availability cluster. HA cluster are often used to provide mission critical service at enterprise environment. And the softwares that are basically used for HA environment is your Pacemaker and Red Hat Enterprise add-on. So the objective of this course module is to deploy and design a high availability cluster environment which will provide active passive failover services or active active service. And this course module is also good for students who are preparing for the certification of a Linux high availability cluster. So let's see what are the course content and what is the prerequisite for this complete course module. So the prerequisite for this course module, you should have the laptop with internet connection, and also you should have the knowledge of Linux. Linux knowledge is required for this course module. At least you are RSCSA, RSC or equivalent knowledge. So let's understand what are the course content. So I have started with the introduction. In the first section of this course module, we have 10 to 12 lectures, that is on the introduction part. In the introduction, we have discussed about what is clustering all about, what are different type of clusters we have, and the advantage of cluster, your cluster architecture, and different concepts and technique like what are resource groups, shared storage, what is forum, what is quorum, what is fancing. So these are very important concept about clustering. And once you have good concept about clustering, the configuration part is not a big deal. And in the lab setup for this entire course module, I have used the KVM environment. So the advantage of KVM environment is that if you have the laptop with enough memory, you can configure the entire cluster setup at your laptop as well, even if you can do it at the home as well. So what does it require? You should have the laptop with more than 8 GB of memory in the laptop, and after that you can install a Linux operating system over to your laptop, or if you want to do it in VMware workstation, you can do it on over to VMware workstation as well. And you need to just install a simple software that is KVM, and over to KVM you can install Linux operating system, your nodes, and that would be your cluster node. So each step I have discussed in this complete course module. In the next section, we have discussed about managing cluster node. So if you have two node cluster, then how you can start and stop any service, how you can disable, enable any service, how you can take any node in a standby node, unstandby node, how you can add or remove a node from a cluster. Suppose if you have a two node cluster, and in future, if you want to add a new node into your cluster, then what are the steps? What would be your approach for that? And also we have discussed about the quorum operation and managing quorum calculations and what are different cluster switches. In the third section, we have discussed about creating and configuring resources. So if you want to provide any service in your cluster environment, then very first thing that is you need to create the resources. So how to create the resources and resources group, that is what we have discussed in this section. And in the next section, we have discussed about troubleshooting high availability cluster. Now, if you have the cluster that is running in your environment, but as a system admin, it's our responsibility to make our cluster up and running all the time. If we have any issue with the cluster, so as a system admin, what would be our approach to tackle the issue? So here we have discussed about inspect and configure cluster logging. If you have any issue as a system admin, first you need to look for which log. And troubleshoot if you have any resource failure is happening with the cluster, then how would I know that, and if the resource is getting failed, and how to resolve such type of issues. Troubleshoot your cluster network issues. In the next section, we have discussed about the complex resource group. So we have, you know, created a lab on that in which I have configured a active passive NFS cluster resource. And in the next section, we have discussed about constraint, managing constraint. So that's very important, you know, if you have any node, if you have any, you know, cluster environment, and we have configured a lot of resources are there. So what would be the order of resources? This resource will start first, and on which node my resources would be started. So that all depends upon how you are doing the constraint. So we have three types of constraint, that is your order, location, and co-location constraint. And with a lot of practice lab session. So this course module is a practical approach. We have done a lot of, you know, practical session to, you know, configure this entire course module. In the next session, we have discussed about two node cluster issues. We know that in a two node cluster issue, we have a lot of issues. The known issues, we can see that. That is, you know, no room for node failure, split brain, your fence death, fence racing. So these are, you know, interview questions, we can say that. If you're going for any interview, interviewer simply asks a step F question. What do you understand by, you know, fencing, your fence racing, your, you know, split brain? So we have discussed all this topic in a practical approach. In the next section, we have discussed about managing iSCSI initiator. So if you have, you know, your own environment and you want to configure your own, you know, storage, and that is on based on LAN IP, then you can configure iSCSI target initiator. So we have discussed about the iSCSI fundamental, the concepts, and how you can, you know, create your own disk, and that would be shared among all your nodes. So this is what we have discussed in that, and a lot of lab sessions to, you know, understand the iSCSI targets and initiator. The next is very important, that is managing high availability logical volume. Now I want to create the logical volume, and my logical volume would be the high availability. So we have two type of, you know, high availability cluster, LVM cluster, that is your clustered LVM or your HA cluster LVM. So we have discussed about the lab session. With the lab session, we have discussed this topic, that is HA LVM. The next one is of managing clustered logical volume. So in this topic, we have discussed about, you know, if you want to make your any service that would be running on all your node. So as of now, we have discussed about active passive. My, you know, service is running at a time on one node. And if that node goes down, what will happen? That service will start running on another node. That is your failover node. But now I want to configure that my service should be running on all the node on all the time. So that is your clustered logical volume. So we have discussed about active configuration of logical volume, the distributed lock manager, the CLVM daemon. So these are the, you know, features about that. So we have discussed about managing cluster logical volume, and to configure the cluster logical volume, we need a special file system, that is a GFS2. We cannot configure a file system that would be mounted on more than one node at the same time. That is not possible with ext4 and XFS file system. For that, we need a GFS2 file system, and GFS2 file system is only meant for clustered logical volume. If you have the cluster set up, then only you can use that file system. So we have in the last section, we have discussed about the GFS2 concepts, creating a GFS2 formatted cluster file system, managing GFS2 file system in a cluster environment. So friend, that's all for this lecture. I believe you are going to learn a lot of things from this course module. Bye-bye. Take care.